Hello and welcome to Bookmess Day 6. I am in the middle of way too many series, 23 to be exact. So let's try to break the number down as much as possible. Starting off with Reckless, which is the second installment in the Powerless trilogy. Hello and welcome back to this new video of mine. I just started reading Reckless. That's actually not true. I've been reading this for a while actually, but I only have 100 pages left and I thought I'm just gonna read it with you because I want to wrap it up. For some reason, this is taking me a very long time to get through and I don't really understand why, because I actually loved Powerless and I actually also loved the world. I love the characters we have in here, so maybe that's why I don't want it to end. That could also be, but on the other hand, I feel like we're not really having any plot in here, it's just vibes. And like, of course we have briefly some plot, but it's just a lot of romantasy. But it's sometimes not the tension I want or was hoping for. We have a lot of good Kai and Peyton moments in here. I've heard that there's also a love triangle forming, which I'm not in the mood for. I don't like love triangles, not really the biggest fan of those. But apparently this is gonna happen in here, which I'm not looking forward to. And I have a suspicion who it's gonna be. I hope I will actually finish this today. I have a little annotation key as well. One about Kai, one about Peyton, and then just quotes or moments that I love. So yeah, I'm gonna finish this up and then I will give you my full opinion, my full review. But we're gonna read a lot of interesting books this video. I want to wrap up a few series that I'm in, or at least in this case continue a series that I'm in, so I'm really excited to share this with you and also being able to just get a few series out of the way that I've started, especially in the fantasy realm, because I've been recently in the fantasy mood, so I want to tackle those right now. So let's do just that. Of the night. It's like 10 p.m. but it feels like it's the middle of the night for me right now, so hence why I look a bit like a mess. But I just finished Reckless and I want to talk to you guys. I thought I wrote some notes down in my phone, but I couldn't find them anymore, so we're just gonna deal with it how it is right now. Right off the bat, I like this one way less than the first book. And just for reference, I mean, I can also link the video where I read Powerless by Lauren Roberts. For me, that one was a 4.5 stars. I was liking it a lot, but it wasn't a 5-star for me. And somehow, some way, this didn't catch my attention as much as I would have liked, as much as I would have thought, actually. Let's just talk about it. So in Powerless, I'm following Peyton and Kai, especially Peyton actually, because she's going through the purging trials, that's what they're called. We're living in a world where there are ordinaries and there are also powerful people, yeah, people with powers, and she is actually an ordinary. In order to hide, she always says she's a psychic, so that's how she hides being an ordinary, because in her world, being ordinary means technically deaf. And Dev is brought by the Enforcerer, which in this case is Kai. Yeah, we meet Kai right off the bat in the first book, in the first chapter almost. They started to have an enemies to lovers connection, I would say. And he's also with her in the purging trial, so basically the first one is like what people say, or also what the author says, a mix of The Hunger Games and Red Queen. And then this one is just a completely different vibe. Like, we don't have the purging trials in here at all. This is obviously the follow-up of the events that happened towards the end of the first book, which were actually really crazy, and I was like very excited to see what's gonna happen and how we're gonna resolve and move on from what happened. I'm waving the book around, I'm sorry. We are actually not resolving it as well as I thought, and I feel like maybe because there was over half a year between me reading the first and now the second one. But for some reason I had troubles connecting with Peyton and Kai. I didn't feel that connection as much anymore. In the first half not so much, but the second half I felt like I was just reading a romance book. Like, I did not feel like I was reading a fantasy book anymore at this point, and we didn't get a lot of politics, which, to be fair, I forgot most of it already. The ending got a bit better again. I'm okay with the ending, I feel like. I also already thought this might happen, like from the way the story was evolving. It's like, I feel like we're getting somewhere in that direction. So I wasn't too surprised. But yeah, in general, I feel like we are in a bit of a sticky situation now. I still feel like I know how the entire trilogy is gonna wrap up. I don't know, I'm just not fully invested anymore, and that makes me a bit sad. So apparently, which I did not notice in the book before, like not in Powerless, but I was also like just getting back into reading at that time. What I noticed is that Lauren Roberts is really into using alliterations, and usually I love a good alliteration or a good anaphora. I really don't mind, but in this case it was just done too much, and especially the first 100 pages took me so long to get into her writing style, because in the beginning I was like, wow, it's so poetic, so beautiful, I love it. But then after a while, if you use too many alliterations, they lose their charm, you know? So I just felt like every word was repeated in a way, or like there was just so much emphasis on like, we need to make it sound poetic so that people can like pick out every single sentence and make it look good. So I'm just gonna choose words that have a similar meaning and start with the same letter. That was a bit disappointing to me, because I feel like if it's overdone and overpowering, then it's just not very strong anymore in a writing style. Like, I like her storytelling, I like her dialogue, I like her banter, I like everything about her writing style but the alliterations. And that actually made me a bit annoyed after a while, because I cannot fall in love with a book if I feel like it repeats itself so much. So I think that's another reason why it took me so long to get through this one, because for me, writing style is actually quite important. I mean, still, it's a great series. I feel like everything wraps up in a very good way, like we can see where it's going. It's just in general, I understand the popularity and the hype behind it, but personally, I'm just gonna say I'm not the biggest fan of the second book. A lot of people also said you can definitely tell that this is an in-between part and that we're gonna get a more lengthy story later on, because this is also, for a fantasy novel, quite a short book, only 400 pages. So that's perfectly fine by me, but that's another reason why I can only rate it 3.5 stars. Like, that's right now where I lay with this. It took me almost a month to get through, and I was too excited for this, actually, which is why I'm a bit disappointed in my reaction and in how little I was into this after a while. I gotta say, Peyton is not my favorite main character, and I don't know why. I really don't know what my issue is, but after a while I was a bit annoyed at her. Like, for example, when we had the novella Powerless, I really loved Adina, and I feel like for me it just highlighted the difference between the two of them. And kind of after reading the novella, I noticed that I'm not really connecting and resonating with Peyton as much. Also, Kai in my head is such a hot looking guy and such a perfect man with all the words he finds and everything, which is why it surprises me sometimes that he's so self-critical and thinks about himself as a beast or something, you know, but that he's like ugly to look at, sort of. Like, that's how he acts sometimes, and I'm like, okay, like, I get it, you're like a bit shy, maybe, I don't know, or like a bit self-conscious, but I feel like it's a bit too much at times. Come on, you know, like, you're the strong, hot male lead in this book, in this romanticy. I want you to be soft, and I want you to have emotions, of course, but if you're good looking, why are you concerned? And also, he switches so fast in character. Like, first he's concerned, and then he slips on another mask where he's confident again and flirty and whatever. I don't know, I hope we're gonna see more behind the curtain there. I feel like I need to understand that a bit more. I understand that he has trauma and that he went through a lot of stuff, but I need to understand more his insecurity about how he physically looks, because that's something I don't fully get yet, or I just got it wrong. That could also be. Overall, Reckless for me, 3.5 stars as of right now. And I'm glad that for now we knocked the series off my reading list, because now I read all of the books that are out right now from the series. So we can just wait for the third book now and chill a little. Very happy about that. And now up next, I want to read From the Grave by Cressley Cole. I told you guys already that, I mean, I'm not gonna read it tonight. I'm way too tired. I think you can hear it in my voice. But I already told you in my 4 book recommendations video that I loved Poison Princess. This is the entire Poison Princess Arcana Chronicles series, whatever you may want to call it. And it's a very interesting premise, but this is actually the final installment. So if I read this, the entire series will be wrapped up, which it's crazy to say, but also very exciting. I've been reading this series since I was 13 years old, and now I'm 22. So I'm also ready to wrap it up now, but I'm also feeling like I'm gonna miss these characters. It's actually only shortly above 300 pages, so I think I'm gonna fly through this one. Let's see, we're gonna experience this together. I read the first paragraph yesterday and I was so confused, because I was like, shit, I don't remember any of this, and that makes it a bit difficult, obviously. So let's see how this goes. Actually, I'm gonna keep you posted. I don't know. Little jump scare. Sorry guys, I just feel so sluggish today. I have my coffee here, but I also feel like I might need a tea or something. Not that anyone cares, but I feel like I'm developing a cold right now. It's also raining all day and it's gloomy outside, so... But usually on those days, I try to get a bit more reading done. And I got a little bit more reading done indeed. Not as much as I would like, but I'm almost halfway now. So this is my halfway check-in. I'm a bit disappointed. I don't like it as much as I used to. I feel so bad just saying that right now because I had such high hopes for this because it's the final installment in the series. And like, I just hoped it would all wrap up nicely, but it just all feels so dragged out. Like, I mean, this is the 7th book in the series. I'm back on track though. Like, I know what was happening and I know like the past occurrences. Is that how you say it? So I feel like I am not terrible at understanding like the politics of this entire thing again, because it's a fantasy, so it just is a bit slower to read at times. It's a different fantasy, like not dragons and stuff, but still. What I find very irritating though is because we always have like the POVs of people, and then we have after the flash, so now we are at day 802 after the flash, and the book started at day 587 after the flash. If we just do a quick little math right now, in this book we have over 200 days, so 230 days almost, after the flash, and I'm just halfway through. So this is almost an entire year that the first half of this book is playing in, and the other 6 books were all over the course of under 2 years. I feel like the pacing is off, and for some reason that makes me feel like we're missing a lot of key information in here that we should have had. Like, there's no build-up, there's no, like, tension. We have sometimes, like, dangerous situations or situations where you're like, oh, now something is happening. A second later, it's being resolved. Within the same chapter, there's no, like, real build-up, there's no drama. I don't feel like there's any pressure right now. At this point, I'm reading it to be done because I want to know how it ends, but I feel like we're really just stuck in a circle right now and nothing really is happening, and I am afraid that in this much of the book, this is where stuff is gonna happen. That's what I feel like right now, and I don't know, maybe it's gonna pick up now from the halfway mark. That's all I gotta say. We just finished this room and it's so cozy. I love it here. This is so nice. Not that you care, because this is not what the video is about, but I'm just excited. So I'm gonna finish up from the grave. I have about this much left, which is really not far. Ignore my mess, I am sick recently, so I just really don't care anymore. But what I don't love is what has been happening in the past few pages. I'm not sold. I don't love this book. I don't love the direction we're headed, so I just want to finish it at this point because I only have like 70 pages left. It's a train wreck. I'm not here for it. I'm gonna chill here, drink my tea, and just enjoy this cozy bed right now. I haven't been able to read in bed like this for like 2 months. This is so lovely. I just finished this today. Oh, that was weird. That was one of the worst reading experience I've had in a very long time, to be honest. Yeah, I'm just very sad to announce that I cannot recommend this to you. I feel like it did not wrap up the series very nicely. We were having a love triangle. The way this resolved, I was not a fan of. I just in general felt like we were being told a lot of things and not shown, and like that's just the biggest rule, like show don't tell, and that was just continuously being disregarded in this book. I just feel like everything was so straightforward. The resolution of the entire thing was so cliche. Like, I don't want to say too much, I don't want to spoiler, but I just feel like it was not worth it to read for 7 books and then this is the conclusion, right? Like, this was not satisfying to me at all. I'm really disappointed by that. I think I want to land at 2.5 stars. I first thought of 3 just because of like how fond I am of the series, or how fond I thought I was, but no, disappointing. I also started the second installment in The Crowns of Nyxia. But I don't know, I'm not really getting into it right now. Like, I'm reading it on my Kindle and I'm gonna continue reading it, but I feel like I'm also wanting to pick up From the Grave just to also read a physical book and not just a Kindle book. So I'm gonna read those 2 at the same time. That was my thought process behind it. I'm about I don't even know, 20% to Crowns of Nyxia right now. It's fine. I'm not really connected to the characters. I'm not really feeling it right now. Don't know how they're gonna resolve the situation because it's a bit tricky right now with everything that's been happening. I just came back from the gym, but regardless, I deemed it important to share with you how far I got in The Ashes and the Star Curse King. Yeah. So ignore my hair, please. It's a mess. I'm a mess. I'm tired. Let me open up my Kindle for a second. Wait, it's waking up. And I'm falling asleep, it feels like. Okay. So I am 63% into the book and I have 3 hours and 48 minutes left. I am excited to get it over with, to be honest. Like, it's picking up on speed, but the first 30-40% of the book were so difficult for me to get into. I had the same with the first book though, but there I was a bit more excited. Now I just felt like it's a drag. I was not really into it anymore. I didn't feel the connection between the characters at all. I was just a bit bored of everything that was going on there, and now we're picking up. Now there are a few developments. Nothing that I didn't see coming yet. Like, I'm not surprised by anything, to be fair, but I mean, in the last book that also happened towards the end, like, that something shocking happened. As of right now, it's nice. Like, we're getting more insights into Oraya, I don't know how to pronounce her name, life, and yeah, how everything is going after the trials now in the first book. I mean, it's a vampire story. I'm not really much into vampires anymore, I think. It's a bit weird to me, like, when they suck blood and everything. I'm not really, I don't know, not really sold, but that's my personal issue, that's my personal preference. The first book I rated 4 stars. I think the novella I gave like 4.25 or something. So I liked them, but I don't love them. You know, they're good. Like, I don't think I can rate this one below a 4 as well. Now it's hooking me, now I'm into it, but still, I'm just excited to be able to finish up the series. So that's my update I have for now. I'm gonna tell you more about the book once I finished it, of course. Also what the first book was about. I talked to you guys about this one in my Finding a 5-star Read video, actually, about the first book in the series. But yeah, as I said, I'm just glad to wrap it up, but I'm not really into it. And I'm a bit sad about that. Like, I would have liked to be, you know, I would have liked to be invested, but somehow that isn't happening. It's not my favorite romantasy series as of right now, or fantasy, because like, we get a little bit of romance, but it's definitely not as much as I would have thought. So it's more fantasy, I would say. Here I have, for example, have Nectar of the Wicked, and here I would say that's probably more of a romantasy. I mean, I haven't read this one yet, but it just sounds completely like a romantasy. Like, the premise is already that she's gonna fall for him, even though she shouldn't, I guess. So that's basically not what is happening in The Ashes and the Star Cursed King. And it's about Aurea's story and also about Rain's past and everything, but it's not about them together most of the time. Like, we see that he is falling for her, and we see that she is still in love with him, and we see that she also has like mixed emotions towards him. So like, we see all of that. We already saw that in the first book. Like, I'm not spoiling much right now, because as already discussed online, like, it is a romance book. Like, it's romance in there, so I don't think I'm surprising anyone when I say this. But still, it's not as much as I would have hoped for. It's not as much as I would have liked. It's still good, but is it hitting as hard as I would like it to? I don't think so right now. I just finished The Ashes and the Star Cursed King, and I'm gonna be completely transparent and honest with you. This video took me way too long to film. Reading, especially The Ashes and the Star Cursed King, took me so long. I mean, it is over 600 pages long, but to be fair, I was also not really hooked, you know? Like, I mean, Powerless, the first one, I was able to read within a few days. And I don't know, the entire The Serpent and the Wings of Night series, or Crowns of Nyxia series, I enjoyed, but I wasn't connected to the characters, I wasn't fully hooked. The ending of the first one got me a bit more into it, but to be fair, like, it's just not for me, I think. I don't think I will actually continue the series. It's very good though. Like, I know it's weird to say it's a good series. I'm just wanting to say the writing style is very good. Like, the way she comes up with stories, the way she writes the plot and the characters is very thought through and is very, very good. So I understand that a lot of people like the book. For me, something just didn't click, which is why personally I did not like it. Or I liked it, but it was like stagnant, you know? I'm not gonna say this is the best book I've ever read. It's also not the worst book I've ever read. So I'm just like in between. I think I'm gonna rate the book that I read now, the last one in the series for now in the duology, maybe 3.5 stars. I feel like it's even too low to say 3.5, just because it is so well written. I love how she just finds words for everything that are so beautiful. I don't know, she just has a very good prose. It's just the storyline that wasn't for me, I think. 3.5 stars, maybe 3.75, but I don't think I want to rate it a 4, to be honest. Like, I don't think that's for me. If you have Kindle Unlimited or something, just start getting into it, maybe start reading it, because it's definitely a good book. Like, it's not a bad romantasy at all, or fantasy romance. Not at all. Which is why I maybe would still recommend it to you if you're like maybe into trials and a lot of war and politics and all that stuff. For me, I think it was also just a little bit too little romance in there. Overall, still good series. I am quite disappointed with all the books in this video, actually. Like, there wasn't one where I was really, really hooked, where I was really excited after I was like reading it for a while to pick it back up. So we finished two series and we continued one. This was a bit of a disappointing video. I was so excited to start it, but yeah, I don't know. But regardless, thank you so much for watching. I hope you have a beautiful and blissful day. Bye!